Hi guys, Unusual Suspects here. After our fight scene video, we now made this one about our favorite battle scenes. 5 picks each, hope you enjoy. Be warned, there will be some minor spoilers. My first pick is the final sea battle in the movie Master and Commander, The Far Side of the World. This movie is rooted in realism, and that is what drew me to choose it. The initial battle comes out of nowhere and takes us by surprise. And then you basically have the rest of the movie to build up to the final battle. And it's just amazing. The smoke, the chaos, the sounds, everything makes us believe that we are actually watching real life. You also have good strategy being employed, especially since our protagonists are at a disadvantage. The scene also doesn't shy away from the brutality of it all, and doesn't glorify the violence that is happening. Definitely worth to check out.
Yeah, definitely. That movie is amazing. I really agree with everything you said. It's a must-watch movie. My first pick is gonna be Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King, the final battle. This one is one of the best ones of all time, in my opinion, due to its magnitude and importance to the story. It's the ultimate clash between the forces of good and evil, and the fate of the world is hanging on the outcome of this battle alone. Before it begins, it's clear that it involves large armies, but most of the details are kept in the dark. When it actually starts, you get that surprise of being even greater than it seemed. Huge numbers, different technology, and then you get that olifant charge, which was amazing. The way it was shot, the timing of the different armies and characters coming into play, and seeing the perspective of the different parties was excellent. The actors did a great job of transmitting all that emotion. Everything combined made these scenes become almost the definition of an epic battle.
I mean, yeah, I agree with everything you said. I mean, it's just an amazing battle. Now that you mentioned it, I have to talk about Helm's Deep battle in the second Lord of the Rings movie. I mean, this is a fantasy-based battle, but it's still grounded on very real elements. I think that the reason that I like this battle so much is because of all the different elements that come into play, and you can clearly see strategy as well as fighting. You have infantry, archers, battery ram, rock throwing, explosives, ladders, secret doors, cavalry charges, and even shield sliding. That's just amazing. Awesome score and cinematography does the rest.
That movie is amazing, and especially for that battle. I think that battle alone brought that movie to the same level as the first and the third one. Next up, I chose Kingdom of Heaven, the Siege of Jerusalem, because of how well it was made, the cultural value embedded into it, and the greatness of the battles. You can feel how important Jerusalem is for both factions and what is at stake. The power struggle is palpable, and the interactions between the different types of characters elevates this movie to a high standard. The variety of tactics, weapons and details they used, the transitions and special effects made this scene memorable and impactful. The skill of the actors, writers, director and everyone who contributed to that gave this movie a deep and meaningful message, and consequently amazing battle scenes. Must watch as well.
Yeah, I mean, Ridley Scott always does a great job recreating history, and especially visually. My next pick is one that had a lot of impact on me when I was a kid. The D-Day landing scene from Saving Private Ryan. I think this was the first war movie that made me realize that war isn't exactly fun or glorious. Even before they landed, I understood that it would be different from other more mainstream war movies. All the shaking of the camera and the gloomy lighting gave out a very real vibe. The scene is basically what I consider to be the most realistic and truthful representation of what happened that day. Pure carnage and violence. But still with the right amount of strategy and character introduction. There is other good examples of landings in movies. The ancient times landing of the Greek forces in Troy. And an also quite violent representation of the World War II landing in Peleliu Island on the HBO show The Pacific. But the Saving Private Ryan one is still my favorite one. Once you've seen this, you won't forget it.
Definitely, this is probably the most famous war movie of all times, and with reasonable credits. Alright, now Red Baron. I chose this movie because of the care in which they showed the air battles in World War I. I had no idea how complex and difficult these battles were, and in this movie they realistically showed how it really happened. The different aerial maneuvers and the different techniques they showed to take the upper hand was incredible. And in those days, a good pilot was a mathematician, a physicist, a mechanic, a marksman, all in one. Also, doing it while exposed to the elements and consequently their survivability depending entirely on the skill. Worth watching just for how amazing these battles were back then. Really great.
My fourth pick is from the show The Pacific, specifically from the Okinawa episode. The reason I chose this episode is because it shows how unbearable and disgusting the reality of war is. You have a battle that goes on for days without that much movement. They are just stuck in the same place, losing their sanity little by little. It reminded me a little bit of the trench war in World War I. That place is simply a living hell. The most shocking aspect of it all was seeing civilians being killed, either by bullets, shells, or bombs. The battle ends, but you keep feeling that nothing much got achieved. This is really one of the most heart-wrenching battles I have ever seen.
So now I decided to choose the 300 movie. This pick has more to do with the artistic value of the battles. The techniques they used were well placed, the speed ups and slowdowns, the visual effects were a major factor in this movie's success, I think. The music was great, the actors for the most part did a great job, and the storyline and concept was okay. I was thinking the movie would be based more on actual events with a more accurate portrayal of history, but it's not a big issue. Nonetheless, if they did it, I think it would have been even more impressive. All in all, good battle sequence, extremely entertaining to watch, I recommend it.
I think this one is more for the sheer entertainment of it all. My last pick is the final battle in The Last Samurai. You have Imperial troops versus the samurai and Tom Cruise. This one is interesting because of the tragedy of it all. I mean, we're following the samurais for the entire movie and they are all decimated in one major battle. Of course, in reality, we would probably be rooting for the Imperials to win, since the samurai were kind of an obsolete elite that kept the rest of the people in ignorance. So the reality is more complex, but the movie is very good in making us connect with the samurai, so we want them to win.
What happened to the warriors at Thermopylae?
Dead to the last man.
And of course, that doesn't happen. But they use smart strategies and still fight till the end. Ending with a powerful and epic cavalry charge in a very powerful and emotional scene.
Yes, definitely. This movie was really great. The battles were really powerful. Really great, great movie to watch. Alright, for my last pick, I chose Alexander the Great. This pick was mostly because of the real battle they portrayed and the real person, Alexander the Great. He was probably the best general in history. He was never defeated in battle. In this movie, I like the fact that they followed what really happened in history. Alexander's army was outnumbered by a factor of 1-4. There are some discrepancies with the actual numbers from historical evidence, but still, they went into battle. That's crazy. On this battle, they had to adapt to the situation. There is no way 70,000 men have the strength and stamina to kill 250,000, even if they were unharmed. So they had to find a way to demoralize their forces into routing, and they did it with an amazing strategy. Alexander's cavalry detached from the main army and went parallel to Darius' army. Darius took the bait and sent part of his army to intercept them, but on doing so, they created a breach on the front lines. The Alexander's cavalry immediately took advantage of that and charged through it. Darius retreated, leaving his army leaderless and demoralized. The Battle of Gaugamela is known throughout history, and Alexander the Great is still envied and worshipped today by generals and military leaders. A must-watch movie.
You could run to the end of the earth, you coward! But you'll never run far enough!
Alright guys, that's it from us. Please let us know in the comments below if you know of any good battle.
And yeah, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.